Hey, my name is Jimmy Raven. I'm the Fortify Product Manager, and I'm here today to show you how to use SourceAndLibScanner. So if you browse to the Fortify Marketplace, you will see the posting under open source for the SourceAndLibScanner. You can just Google Fortify Marketplace, and it'll take you right in. And look under open source, and you will see the Fortify SourceAndLibScanner. So I'm going to go ahead and download that. And I'm going to save it on my desktop. And let's just unzip this guy. All right, and inside of here, you will see the SourceAndLib 20.1 zip, and you'll see the PDF, which is the documentation. So we're going to go ahead and unzip this. I'll show you how to install it. We've released this directly to the marketplace. It will be included with the SCA and Apps tool suite starting in 20.2 this fall. So you won't have to download it separately and merge it in. But until that time, you can download it from the marketplace, and I'll show you how to manually install it. This works with both 19.2.2 SCA and 20.1. So all we need to do is grab the bin and core folders, just copy those to our clipboard, go to our applications. We can choose either 19.2.2 or 20.1, and we're going to go ahead and paste it in for here, and I'm going to choose merge. Okay, now that we have done that, we are ready to get started. So let's grab a terminal, and if we were to type SourceAndLibScanner -H, we will see the help that is displayed. So I'm going to walk you through a few commands and some, give you the general usage of the SourceAndLibScanner. So if we look at this slide right here, you can see that the SourceAndLibScanner's intention is to scan your code with Fortify Static Code Analyzer and Sonatype via the shared Fortify and Sonatype open source component scanning service, and then upload those results to SSC. Or you can scan your code with SCA and Sonatype and upload the results to SSC and include the Sonatype's on-premise Lifecycle product, Nexus IQ Server. Or you can do either or. So just run an SCA scan or run a Sonatype scan. A quick note, if you want to do the Sonatype only option, you will have to use our build tool none option, which I will show you. So let's go ahead and put up a terminal. And I am going to grab our first example. So our first example, I will paste it in here. It is using a manual SCA scan. We provide the ability to just directly paste in any of your translation arguments into TARGs and any of your scan arguments into SARGs. We can see here that the Sonatype libscan URL is on the open source component service that I mentioned earlier. This is our Sonatype entitlement that you would receive once you purchased it. And then I'm also choosing to upload these results to SSC. And this is the token and the version ID that I'd like to be in SSC. So I'm going to go ahead and enter this command. You'll see we'll run a local SCA scan here. We're going to parse these files, run our scan, and then we should move on to the Sonatype step, where we're going to fingerprint any third-party dependencies that are available in this Java project. And we're going to see what known vulnerabilities we have associated with that. And because we are choosing to use the data feed service and SSC, those results will be sent directly to SSC alongside with the Fortify SCA results. So we can see the scan is running here for fingerprinting. Took 6 seconds submitting that scan. We are downloading the report, and then we will convert that report and upload the results to SSC. So if we take a quick look and bounce over to SSC, we should be able to group by analysis type. You can see Fortify SCA issues here, and you can see your Sonatype issues here. So we have our known vulnerabilities. Right. We have our common weakness enumeration for this particular vulnerability. You would have the CVE the vulnerability disclosure information, everything you need to know is available in those links in terms of deciding whether or not this is an issue you wish to address. So if we go back to our terminal, the next example I'm going to show you uses a new feature to SourceAndLibScanner with regards to SCA. And this is using our auto packaging feature that you may be familiar with Scan Central that will then also use the same Sonatype open source component service. So here are the differences. I'm using the dash auto flag. The build tool I'm setting to none. That also can be set to Gradle or Maven for this. SourceAndLibScanner currently supports Java. We will be testing other languages and adding support for that. But in the first release of this, it does support Java only. So we are basically creating a payload and passing it to a local copy of SCA that we're running here. And then we're using the same Sonatype service that we used previously. So we'll go ahead and kick that off. We'll see the SCA portion of that. And then I'll kill the scan and we'll go on to the next one since it's exactly the same as the previous. So let's just make sure this is going to work properly. The package generation finish, it's starting the SCA scan. And essentially the results would be the same. We were setting the build ID and the source files in our TARGs and SARGs in the previous command. And here we're simply providing build tool none, which is going to, when invoked in the current directory of the source code you wish to analyze, we'll recursively look in the current directory and below, package it up. Or it'll intelligently package it if you use Maven and your palm.xml or Gradle and your build.gradle file. And there's some good uses examples in the help that is included with the CLI as well as with the documentation. So we can see here that this did work and we're going ahead and uploading those results to SSC. So I did want to show you a use case where we would have no Fortify SCA scan, but simply invoke Sonatype results with this utility for Fortify customers. So here we're using the same thing, auto build tool none, but I don't have the dash scan option that I had in my previous command. If we look at my previous command, you'll see the dash scan. So the only difference here is I'm not including the dash scan. So a SCA scan, Fortify SCA scan will not be run. But we will fingerprint and use the Gradle data feed service. So I'll go ahead and kick that off and show you how that works. But essentially the same Sonatype results would filter into that project. You can see we skip the SCA step, we're just running the Sonatype invocation, running the fingerprinter and downloading the results from this remote data feed service and putting it in Software Security Center. We did also consider that you, for existing Sonatype customers who already have the Lifecycle IQ Server product, or for customers who have workflows and features that are not included for SSC but are available in Sonatype IQ, that we can also use and leverage the Sonatype on-premise IQ Server with this SourceAndLibScanner as well. So I'm going to go ahead and show you how to do that. So I'm going to paste in my command. My SCA command is a local scan command like you've seen before with TARGs and SARGs. We did design this so you can copy paste your existing static analysis commands into TARGs if you wish, or if you don't want to change or fortify current existing scans at all, you could just invoke Sonatype if that is better for your workflow. We are invoking the Sonatype's IQ Server CLI jar under the covers, so it's essentially the same thing. If you were to go and grab the Sonatype CLI. So you could use that alternatively. But this tool allows you to combine both SCA and Sonatype. So if we look at the differences in the options, you can see I have the IQ URL, my Nexus authentication, we're required to pass the IQ app ID, the stage, right? And then we're going to upload those results to SSC. So in this scenario, results will be passed to SSC, but they will also we are invoking and calling IQ to then contact the remote server and the same way Sonatype always works with their on-premise IQ server. And we're using that local IQ server to put the results there as well as in SSC. So I'm going to go ahead and kick this off. We'll see the Sonatype the Fortify SCA scan kickoff with that local scan. And then we'll move on to the Sonatype side of this demonstration, and we'll see the fingerprinter run from the IQ server. And we'll see a few additional, some information to the console that we don't see when we're using the remote data feed service. And there we go. We're generating a package for the Sonatype scan, and we're running our scan. You can see I'm leveraging the IQ server, validating the test ID. We are fingerprinting all of the third-party dependencies or compiled binaries here. Waiting for the policy evaluation to complete. We'll get some information about the scan and a scan ID that IQ server provides, as you can see right there. So if we are to bounce over to IQ server, right, we'll be able to come into our components here and view our issues as you would normally in IQ, or alternatively, we could bounce over to SSC to see those same results. The functionality of this utility is quite basic, right? Just combining both Fortify SCA and Sonatype. However, we have some pretty exciting features coming out, most specifically ones in which we are looking to understand methods and functions that are responsible for publicly disclosed vulnerabilities. And this tool is going to facilitate those kind of workflows where we need to invoke Sonatype first, collect some information, and then use that information in SCA scans to show you interesting things like whether dangerous method or functions were invoked or controllable. So look forward to that in the future. And I hope this was informative as far as how to use Source and Libscanner. Thank you very much.